Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making barbecue beef sandwiches. So we start by cooking our beef. And I want to show you what I got for this purpose. This is a 2-pound roast and it was labeled a boneless shoulder roast. I've already seasoned the bottom and this side right here, so I would only have one side to season, and that would lessen my having to wash my hands as I did this. But you just want to salt and pepper it. I did line my slow cooker with aluminum foil, and what I'm going to do is bring that down and enclose it, because that keeps all of the juice inside. And if it's cooked in juice, then it's much more tender than if you let all that drain out to the bottom of your slow cooker. It just kind of settles in the bottom and is sticky and hard to clean. This way it's easy to clean too. So I put the lid on, and I've already turned this to high. You can tell when it's done. If it's falling apart tender, it's done. Now, you don't want red in it at all. We're not cooking it for the purpose of slicing a roast that is rare in the center and more well done on the edge. We're wanting something that would make a good pulled beef sandwich, and you do need the beef done all the way through. I let my beef roast cook in the crock pot on high for 7 hours. I just want to show you what was left behind. There was this much juice, and it looks very nice and rich. So if I were making roast beef and gravy, this would be wonderful for making the gravy. I would get all of the fat off the top and any debris out of it, and then I would use probably cornstarch and water and have a lovely gravy. But that's not our purpose here. We're going to have our own sauce, which is a barbecue sauce. I cooled it completely and then used a knife to do some cutting of the beef, but also trimming all the fat off, because I didn't want any fat left in this beef barbecue sandwich. And I have a result that I'm going to show you right here. So all of that work got done in order to produce the 2 pounds of beef in the form that I need for beef barbecue. I want to tell you about the buns we're going to use. You can use any kind of hamburger bun or sandwich bun, generally round, but it doesn't have to be. And I have these that are whole wheat. Now, they came whole, but I used a knife to slice these. Here is the barbecue sauce that I made. It's in the previous video upload on YouTube if you want to look for that. Or you may use bottled barbecue sauce or another recipe that I have or somebody else has on YouTube. I may have some beef left over, so it's wiser to go ahead and put what you think you'll use all of in your larger saucepan to mix these together. I wouldn't put the beef in first because I might not have enough sauce. I'm pretty sure it will not be a problem the way I'm doing it. So now I want to put beef in, and it should be shredded so that you could put it in a sandwich and it doesn't fall out all over the place because it's so heavy. And when you bite into it, you don't get a long string that you can't really bite through. So just arrange for that to be bite size. And then you can just put a little at a time in. It's getting to the point where I think I would enjoy it at this consistency. So this is our barbecue beef, and I'm going to put it together in a sandwich and serve it. I'm just finishing up the spreading of my barbecue beef sandwich, the second one, and you can see I have about half of my mixture left, so I could get two more easily. And I had about 1/2 pound of meat left over that I did not put sauce on. Let's bring this over to my spot here where I've laid out a few things that I'll explain to you. These are just salad greens that are mixed. I feel like when you have a sandwich like this, you ought to have something green to go with it. I have some sliced tomatoes that came from our garden, from Rick's garden actually, because we're getting so many right now. And over here on my plate, I have something, a snack that's called harvest snaps. These snap peas are wasabi ranch, and these lentils are tomato basil. So I've already tasted both of them. They're really good, and they're baked, which is a little bit better than having a fried chip. So I just thought I'd mention it to you in case you run across those. I'll let you see what it looks like inside. It will drain into the bread, so expect it to look like that. It tastes really good. That sauce really complements the beef flavor. For me, it's perfect. The beef was cooked perfectly. It's nice and tender. Don't feel like you have to do it just like I did. You just need some beef. And if you'd rather use this on chicken, then you could get a rotisserie chicken, pull the skin off, and then pull that. Also, if you want to use pork, this would make a good roast pork sandwich or pulled pork sandwich. Any kind of barbecue that you like, even if you want to do chicken on the grill or hamburgers or steak on the grill, then this barbecue sauce will taste fine with it. I love it, and I think you will too.